career began with my endorsement of the pen. I secured other endorsements for her, introduced her to important clients. I gave her her start, but it was her own talent and imagination that enabled her to rise to the top of her profession and stay there. She had an eager mind always. She was always quick to seize upon anything that would improve her mind or her appearance. Laura had innate breeding. But she deferred to my judgment and taste. I selected a more attractive hairdress for her. I taught her what clothes were more becoming to her. Through me, she met everyone, the famous and the infamous. Her youth and beauty, her poise and charm of manner captivated them all. She had warmth, vitality. She had authentic magnetism. Wherever we went, she stood out. Men admired her. Women envied her. She became as well known as Waldo Leidecker's walking stick and his white carnation. But Tuesday and Friday nights we stayed home, dining quietly, listening to my records. I read my articles to her. The way she listened was more eloquent than speech. These were the best nights. Then one Tuesday she phoned and said she couldn't come. It didn't matter, really. But when it happened again the following Friday, I was disturbed. I couldn't understand it. I felt betrayed. And yet I knew Laura would never betray anyone. I walked for a long time. Then I found myself before her apartment building. The lights were on. It pleased me to know she was home. Till I saw she was not alone.